Welcome back to Sister Circle Live. All week long, we have been catching up with our favorite female judges on daytime TV during our Sisters of the Court week.
Our next guest is laying down the law on the court TV show, The Verdict with Judge Hatchett, as only she can do. Take a look.
You played him. You played him. And had he not asked for the testing, which then you got, quote unquote, offended by, you know, he'd still be assuming that this child was his. And you knew in your heart of hearts that there's a possibility that it wasn't. That's wrong. It's absolutely wrong.
All right. Please welcome the Honorable Judge Hatchett.
Yes!
Hello!
Hello! You are just fabulous.
Super cute!
I mean... This is royalty personified.
How are you?
So glad to see you
good
all.
Good to see you.
It's so good to be back.
Yes.
Good to have you.
Love how much I love you all.
And we love you so much.
My goodness, this just this whole, just everything.
Oh, thank you. I love what you're doing this week by having us all here.
Isn't that
amazing.
Right. Has any other talk show ever done that?
Of course not.
Of course.
Of course not.
Of course, because we are just lovely, aren't we?
Just as you are.
Yeah. And speaking of which, the city of Atlanta gave you a proclamation. What did that feel like for you?
Well, you know, I'm from Atlanta, born and raised here. And so, I cried. I just cried. But it was very special because it meant so much to be honored by your hometown.
Yes.
It really was very
absolutely.
Special.
Understood. Both of us are native, so I absolutely feel the joy.
Yes.
I feel the joy. I also feel the joy with you and your mother.
Yay.
About to be 98 years old. Young. How about that?
98 years. And she was at the proclamation. She's been sick a lot, but she is just amazing.
Look at her.
98 years old. What a blessing.
I mean,
a blessing. A blessing.
Such a blessing.
Yes.
Awesome.
Well, I hate to shift gears like this, but the last time you were here, you talked about losing your daughter-in-law, Kira Johnson.
Right.
And about your initiative of making it more aware of how black women are less likely to get the attention that they need when they're hospitalized and when they have childbirth. Right. So can you tell us about the initiative now?
Yes. So since we last talked, and a lot of this is because you all have gotten really behind us and made this so much of a conversation that I'm really happy to tell you that the U.S. Congress has passed, the first time ever in history in this country, a maternal health care bill.
Oh, God.
We are really good. And Charles has really been, and the boys are there on that picture, are in the state capitol downtown. Really lobbying, because also we're working on the national level, but Georgia is number 50th in the country. Mm-hmm. We are the worst.
Oh, my goodness.
And the CDC, I have to tell you also very briefly, just did a release in September, and now they said that we are 3 to 4 times more likely to die because of childbirth as black women, but now they're saying they think it's more like 4 to 5 times more likely, and the worst in the industrialized world. So there's still a lot of work to do, and Kira for Moms is really busy on that. So I hope people will continue to follow it because the work has to continue. A 2-year-old comes in your room in the middle of the night and says, Grandma G, why won't God let mommy come home?
Yeah.
We don't want any other family
to feel that
kind of pain.
Yes, absolutely. I'm so glad you're doing this work, though. We're so very happy because people now, when they go into the hospital, they're more vigilant, they're more aware to speak your truth and make sure somebody comes in there.
And we've gotten that.
Yes.
We've gotten that. My wife would have died, my sister would have died, my daughter would have died, but we knew Kira's story.
Yes, absolutely. Beautiful. And the Hatchett firm.
Yes.
I mean, female-owned. Talk about the significance of what you're continuing to do with your amazing career.
Well, thank you. And I will tell you, I really prayed about this. But I really feel that this time in my life, I need to be on this side of the bench, that I need to be advocating for people. And so I'm proud to tell you that I am the only black woman to have a national law firm. So I take cases from all over the country.
Wow.
We talked about Philando Castile's case in Minnesota, wrongful death, catastrophic injury. So we're still fighting the good fight.
Yes, that's beautiful.
Well, let's talk about The Verdict with Judge Hatchett.
Yes.
see me get on that one?
Yes, you did.
At this point in your career, what is your favorite part about being on the bench?
I think that it really is about being able to touch people that you don't know that you touched.
Yes.
So I don't care where I am. I can be in a busy airport. I can be in the grocery store, wherever. And people come up and say, you know what, Judge? I felt like you were talking to me. Mm-hmm. You know, I went into drug treatment, or I left an abusive spouse, mm-hmm. or I got a relationship back with my child. So yeah. I really think that that's, for me, what is so fulfilling about being doing this work.
Well, we're going to talk about some more things that's fulfilling in your life when we return, including this beautiful necklace.
Yes.
We'll tell you where you may be able to get it. More Judge Glenda Hatchett when we return.
I'm going to take it off her neck.
And we are back on Sister Circle Live with the lovely Judge Glenda Hatchett.
Woo!
So let's talk about this amazing jewelry line, the Executive Collection.
Yes.
Why? I mean, you've always been super duper fly.
Yes.
So it's only natural that you
Well, I do them a lot on the show. Mm-hmm. And people have always said, well, you know, what's going on with these? And so there is, there are these two young guys. They're like not even 30 years old.
Wow.
Darius is the designer, Dallas is the business manager, and so we decided that we would do this
mm-hmm.
because they were doing pieces for me,
right.
and people would stop me or they'd see it on the show, and so we're gonna introduce this line. And so they're all natural stones.
Yes.
They are all handmade,
mm-hmm.
and so once the 2020 collection is done, you can't buy it.
Oh.
You see what I'm saying? So then there'll be a 21 collection, a 22 collection.
That's nice.
And so they're limited edition. And so you have to get it. And so we'll have six pieces
right
in the
now,
I love it.
Okay, so in honor of Sisters of the Court Week, we are going to play a game called Under Oath.
Ooh.
So raise your right hand.
Yes.
Do you swear to tell the truth, the whole truth, so help you go according to Sister Circle?
Absolutely according to Sister Circle.
Okay.
All right.
We're going to ask you a question.
All right.
Okay, Tree B.
All right, first question. Okay. Have you ever lied about your child's age?
No, I haven't.
Oh.
No, I really haven't.
No free lunch, no free dinner?
Mm-mm, I haven't.
Okay.
I did.
Because you know what? My kids are so smart. They would have gone like, Mama, that's not right. Put me all on the air.
Right.
So, no, that's the only reason I didn't do it.
Okay. Right, because of your kids. Okay, have you ever faked sick to call out of work?
Oh, yeah, I have.
Yeah. Yes.
Yes, I have.
Even on the judge, like when you had to do it?
No, not when I was on the bench.
Okay.
No,
okay.
I would go in there huffing and coughing and carrying on. Like,
right.
Last one. This goes all the way back.
All the way back.
We got 15 seconds.
Have you ever cheated on a test?
Yes.
Oh, what? But it wasn't the bar.
It wasn't the bar. I did have some stuff written on it.
Right. Well, thank you so much, Judge Hatchett. We love you.
Thank
Please
you.
Be sure to check out your local listings to watch The Verdict with Judge Hatchett and follow her on Instagram at Judge Hatchett. And the conversation always continues on Sister Circle TV on all social media platforms.
Sure does.
Yes.
All right.
Thank you.
Thank you.